Have you ever wondered how the great fortresses of the Middle Ages were built? Today, machines raise skyscrapers in just a few months. But in the Middle Ages, every stone was lifted by hand. Stones was usually quarried locally. Sometimes a new quarry was opened right next to the construction site to reduce the burden of transport. Masons used iron picks, hammers, and wooden wedges. They drove the wedges into natural cracks and poured water over them. As the wood swelled, the solid rock split apart. Special groups of masons shaped the stones directly on site, reducing their weight and making transportation easier. Stones were hauled on wooden carts drawn by oxen or horses. If a fortress stood by a river, the blocks were floated downstream on barges, saving enormous effort and time. We know these techniques not only from archaeology, but also from medieval manuscripts. For example, the sketchbook of Villers de Honnecourt, written in the 13th century. Before construction began, huge trenches were dug for the foundations, sometimes several meters deep. Next to the construction site, lime kilns were built to prepare mortar, the true glue of medieval masonry. Limestone was burned at temperatures above 900 degrees Celsius, producing quicklime, the essential ingredient for medieval mortar. Sand was added to the slaked lime, creating the mortar that bound the stones together. Each stone was carefully shaped on the workbench to fit the future masonry. Marked by its mason, every block carried a symbol, a way to count the work and ensure its quality. Wooden scaffolds rose with the walls level by level. Square holes in the masonry held beams that supported the planks, allowing workers to climb higher as the fortress grew. The massive treadwheel crane lifted stones higher and higher. With ropes and wood alone, medieval builders raised blocks weighing tons, setting them into the fortress walls. The fortress walls were built with two outer layers of stone, while the inside was packed with earth and rock. This gave the walls their enormous mass and strength. It was not only stone and lime. Huge amounts of timber were needed for scaffolding, cranes, and lifting machines. Entire forests were cut down for a single castle. Building a fortress could take decades, sometimes 20, 30, even 50 years. Generations of masons and carpenters worked side by side, passing their craft to their sons. What would you like to see next? Write in the comments.